Hey, this is Mikey with another After Effects tutorial. This video, I'm going to show you how to do this hand-drawn animation look. Best part is, it's completely dynamic and it's not at all hand-drawn. Now, I know you can't fully replace the aesthetics and the look of hand-drawn animation, but that doesn't mean you can't get a cool kind of hand-drawn look that's dynamic in After Effects. So let's start with a brand new composition. I called it streaky because I'm making these little streaks. Let's bring in just what we're going to be animating. So let's make a big M for motion. And then I'm going to take this, and since I want it dynamic, I'm going to pre-compose this so I can just swap out this footage with whatever in the future. So Command-Shift-C or Control-Shift-C. Let's call this footage. Now, I am going to be doing lots of pre-comps in this, so try to pay attention. Now, let's take this footage layer, duplicate it, take this bottom version of it, and pre-comp this again. Command-Shift-C or Control-Shift-C. Let's call this Streaks. Now, let's go into the Streaks comp, and we're going to take this and duplicate it. The top layer, let's rename that to Stretch, and the bottom layer to Streaks. Now, we do have to take this Streaks comp and pre-comp that again. Let's just call this the Streaks comp. Okay, now lots of pre-comping, but that's all there is right now. So now let's go into the Streaks comp, highlight the Streaks layer, and let's add some effects. Let's go down to Generate, Cell Pattern, and let's go in here and let's increase the contrast. Increase the disperse rate, or the disperse angle. Maybe even more contrast, and maybe bump the size up just a tiny bit. Now let's go to keying, and let's add an extract filter. Let's knock out that black. And then let's add a tint to make it all white. So let's go back into the streaks comp. Let's turn off this stretch layer. Let's have it a black background again, and I need to make an adjustment layer. So if we go to Layer, New, Adjustment Layer, and this needs to be between the Streaks comp and the Stretch comp. So on this adjustment layer, let's add a time echo effect. Let's change this echo time to -0.0006 and the decay to 0.98. and the number of echoes to 200. Now, just to show you what this is doing, let's do a quick animation. So I'm gonna, on this position, I'm gonna keyframe this. Just go 5 frames. And as I move, you can see it's creating these streaks. That's pretty cool. So let's go ahead and let's take that keyframe data off. Now let's take this echo, I'm gonna copy that, and let's put it on this stretch, except for we're going to change the number of echoes to 15. Now we're almost there. So next we got to kind of link things together. So I'm going to take this streaks comp. I'm going to drag it and move it up here into this window. You can see there's a blue highlight at the bottom, and that's now I've got two timelines. And what I can do now is I can come into this main comp and take the footage layer, and I'm going to open up the transform. And so what I want to do is open up the transform on these as well. So let's start with position. I'm going to hold down Option or Alt on the keyboard, click on the stopwatch, and I'm going to link position from this timeline over to this timeline. Same thing with scale and rotation. And let's do the same thing for this stretch comp as well. And we can go ahead and move this back down here. So let's take a look at what we have so far. So if I now animate this position, so I'm going to keyframe the position. And as I move this, it's creating these streaks. And that's pretty cool, but you know, maybe I want to change the way this looks a little bit. And I do. So let's go now into the streaks composition. And because I've got it animated and everything's connected, I can see what this is looking like. And let's add another adjustment layer. And on this adjustment layer, let's add a fast blur. And then go to color correction and levels. Change the levels to alpha. Let's increase the blur. And then let's crunch this alpha. And that's starting to look pretty cool. Let's go back into our main comp. And if that's still maybe too big of streaks for you, if you come all the way over into this, the streaks comp, not just the streaks, but the streaks comp, and then increase the contrast, and we come back over here, and then those are going to be smaller. Let's come in now to the streaks. Decrease the blurriness. And that's starting to be kind of what we're looking for. Let's render this out, see what it looks like. It's looking pretty cool. Now you notice some cool stuff going where we even got bits of it being left behind. And you can even do that even more if we come in to the adjustment layer that's over the streaks comp that has the echo in it. And if we switch this from -0.0006 to say -0.0008, then we're going to have a little bit more of that. Now the cool thing about this is since it's all dynamic, it doesn't matter which direction you're moving, it's still going to animate and have the streaks going in those directions. So if I keyframe the position and move it, say, at a diagonal, you can see it doesn't matter which direction I'm going, it's creating those streaks. Let's delete these keyframes. And let's try a rotation. So I keyframe the rotation. And let's go, say, 90 degrees. Let's see what that looks like. That's pretty darn cool. I'm pretty impressed with that. Now, just to show you how dynamic this is let's come into now the footage layer. Let's take this and let's just put in a rectangle. Let's go back into that main comp. That is pretty impressive. That looks really cool. And that was all just dynamic. Now, this is all using just white shapes and text. So if you want to add color to it, then what you're going to need to do is on this footage and the streaks, you're going to need to add a fill. So we got to go to generate fill. See, it switched it to red. So I can copy this, do it onto the streaks as well. And now, when it rotates, it'll have that red color. So that's how you can change colors pretty easily. Let's try some other different movements. I'm really kind of liking the look of this. Let's try a scale. So let's go change the scale from 100 down to 20%. That's pretty cool. Let's do a combination of movements. So maybe then we go, let's keyframe the scale, the rotation, and the position. Scale back up to 100. Rotation to 90. And position, let's move all the way over here. That is just pretty cool. So there's the tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. I think it was really cool. A lot of stuff you could do with this. So I do want to see what you make with this. So if you have created a video using this technique, go ahead and post it in the comments below. If you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe to the channel. I'm doing tutorials like these every Friday, plus quick tips on Wednesdays. So I would love to have you be a part of the community. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe and share this video with others. And we'll see you next time.